This is day 85, and I've been holding at day 40. So about 2 years ago, I did a 35-day hunger strike, 24-hour day occupation during the wintertime, starting on Christmas Eve, as I recall, on Capitol Hill. After my second reading of Plan B 3.0, in June I finished a 50-day vitamin and electrolyte hunger strike, and am now well over day 40, but as any good soldier, I adjust my hourly minute-by-minute activities to the best way to serve, and there has been some very brain-intensive work, particularly the last week or so. So I continue to do my best to strike a balance between staying faithful to the hunger strike, which is, I better understand, as a fast, because this is not about me demanding action from others. It's about me delivering the committed action that my human family is due from me. My strategic desire has been to use every ounce of strength that fast can lend to my effort, but at the same time to maintain my physical and mental acuity. The backpacking that I do around town, lugging 60 to 80 pounds worth of stuff, some on my back, some in a rolling case, at least an hour a day to the coffee shop where I repower, down a long hill and up a long hill to and from where I sleep, on the streets. The calculations I find online suggest that's 400 calories a day. So, with few exceptions, this has been a net zero-calorie hunger strike, but that's not to say I don't consume calories to offset the backpacking that I do. And sometimes more when I feel that my brain power is suffering. Given the computer work that I've finished, some clandestine, some very much on my various websites, particularly YouTube and the Start Loving blog, being, I think, at a point where I can now taper off significantly, and given a break in the weather, I anticipate that maybe I will be in front of the White House 10 hours a day, maybe 14, 15, 16 hours a day. I seem to be also getting a handle on which of my two computers to use. I'm on my netbook right now, which is a good 50% more energy efficient than my larger, much faster laptop. And again, being past the really computer-intensive, high-processing computer work, I can use the network, or the netbook, more right now. I think with that and my solar panel on sunny days, I'm about 80% off of the grid, therefore less involved with killing my fellow citizens, both U.S. and global, with our burning of coal, which is something I'm very pleased with and very much obligated as your brother to do, as are you. We kill about 12,000 Americans, 12 to 13,000 Americans a year, and sicken thousands of times more with our burning of coal and its pollution. What moral right have you to do that? What excuse have you to do that? What excuse do I have to do that? So yesterday I posted a video log, which I'll be featuring prominently on my YouTube site and blog, Start Loving blog, as a very significant coalescing of where I've been growing to these last dozen years, and specifically where I am relative to everything, including and particularly doing my little part to try and prevent the life support system for Spaceship Earth to be blown out irreparably forever. I highly recommend it. It's up to you, but don't say I didn't offer it. Have been doing much reading recently, Derek Jensen's Deep Green Resistance, which I can't recommend because it is a brilliant attempt, but it winds up being more of the same, more violence, more hostility, more enemies. But I've read it with great care and caution, and have profited by it significantly, and some of the video log I just mentioned is a response to that, and I pray turns into something that steers an otherwise brilliant, maybe most hopeful team, the Deep Green Resistance team, from being more of the status quo to being the change agents they yearn to be and that I desperately need them to become. I am more than halfway through a book called Jesus Interrupted, which is a massively scholarly look at the historical Jesus, from which I'm profiting tremendously, will be more hopeful to my catatonically sick fundamentalist brothers and sisters as I use and over time master some of the insights there. Today, I expect to delve into Diane Wilson's Echo Outlaw book, one of her most recent books, maybe her most recent book. And on my plate are McKibben's Earth and James Hansen's book, Stories for My Granddaughter or something, Grandchildren. And the preeminent eco blogger, environmental blogger, Joseph Rahm, his 2006 book. All of those I expect to be focusing on as I'm here in front of the White House, except for those times when there are people with signs of life that come that want to talk, which is rare, but that's my top priority.